Hello, I'm Liz Duplessis, the Instructional Designer in Distance Education at SRJC. In this video, I'll show you how to
find and set up your Canvas course shells for the new semester, including how to import content and change due dates. Let's get started.
As an instructor, every course you are assigned to teach in the schedule of classes will automatically have a course shell added to your Canvas account. The term shell is used to describe the Canvas user interface that you use to set up and for students to access course content and activities. If you don't see a course shell for a class you're assigned to teach in your dashboard of Canvas, click the Courses icon in the blue global navigation bar and select All Courses. If you'd like the new course shell to appear on your dashboard, click the star icon next to the course until the star turns gold. If you'd like to hide a course from the dashboard, click the star until it turns white. If you don't see your course shell in your All Courses list, please go to de.santarosa.edu, click Canvas Request Forms, and fill out the form Course Shell Missing for Faculty so that our systems administrator can reassign the course shell to you. Starting with Fall 2017 course shells, the default home page is set to Modules, but you can easily change this by going to Home in the course navigation, clicking Choose Home Page, and selecting another option. You can import some or all content from a previous semester's Canvas shell into your new course shells. To import content into a new shell, choose the course shell you would like the content to end up in. Choose Settings from the course navigation. From the right sidebar, click Import Content into this course to import content. In the drop-down menu under Import Content, select the Copy a Canvas Course option. Select the course with the content from the drop-down list. You can also do a search by course name. If you want to import all of the content from the course to be added to the shell, click the All Content Radio button. If you want to select specific content, such as only certain modules, assignments, or quizzes, click the Select Specific Content Radio button. This import process does not overwrite existing content. It simply adds the additional content to your course shell. If you want to adjust the due dates associated with the course events and assignments, click the Adjust Events and Due Dates checkbox. In the Beginning Date field, enter the starting date of the course you are importing, such as January 10, 2017. In the Change To field, enter the new date when you want the course to begin, such as August 20, 2017. Do the same in the Ending Date fields. You can also define day substitutions to adjust for changing class schedules, such as moving all assignments on Mondays to Tuesdays. Click the Substitution button and select days of the week in the Move From and To fields. If you want to remove all associated due dates in the course, select the Remove Dates radio button. Dates will be removed from assignments, announcements, quizzes, and calendar events, as well as module unlock dates. Click the Import button. This may be a little counterintuitive since you haven't yet selected the specific content to be imported, but that's the next step. In the Current Jobs area, click the blue Select Content button once it appears. Depending on how big the imported course shell is, it may take a little while to see the next screen. From the pop-up window, mark the checkbox next to all content categories you want imported. This will automatically select all items within the marked categories. To select only certain items within a category, click the arrow next to the category to open up the list of available items. Select all items you want imported. Click the blue Select Content button. When the green Completed button appears in the Current Jobs area, your content has been imported. Don't worry if the Completed button is orange and shows issues. As long as it says completed, your content was imported. Next, review your course materials for the new semester. You can check that all internal and external links are functioning correctly by using Validate Links in your course settings. Note that the URLs for the SRJC bookstores are now santarosashop.com and petalumashop.com, where students can search for textbooks by course section. If you want to provide a link directly to the textbooks for your section, remember to update that link each semester. You may also wish to unpublish items or modules in your course until they're ready for students to view. Or if you keep them published, which will allow assignments to appear on the calendar and in grades, You can publish and then lock an individual module so students won't access the content until a particular date. The module will unlock automatically on the date you set. You can also customize course navigation links in Canvas. We recommend keeping it simple and hiding navigation elements that are not being used to avoid confusion. If you're using modules to present assignments, quizzes, files, pages, and discussions, those links can remain hidden in your navigation. You can still get to them, but students will only see those in modules. Before you publish your course, use the Student View option found in the right-hand navigation bar on the Settings page to see what your course looks like from the student perspective and check to see that all modules and items are published and updated. You can even submit assignments or quizzes as the test student to verify everything is working properly. When your content is ready, publish your course, which will open it up for student access. For more information on these topics, search the Canvas Guides. Thanks for watching!